now let's welcome your host, Henry Kelly.
Thank you very much indeed. And in honour of the day that's in it, welcome to Going for Gold wherever you're watching us in Europe, and welcome to our studio audience here in London on a very special day, because at last, after 140 contestants, 5,000 questions, 23 weeks, and contestants from 15 different countries, today is the day of the final on Going for Gold, which is why I've taken the old suit out of the mothballs in honour of the occasion. If you are watching us already this week on days 1, 2 and 3, you know that two English contestants, Daphne Hudson and Paul Wallace, are into today's final with Peter Schmidt-Barr from Austria. So we're down to other contestants today. In a moment, we'll get closer to the final. The quiz champion of Europe and this prize.
Fly with us to Korea and share the excitement of witnessing world record achievements as athletes from all over the world gather in Seoul to once again compete for Olympic glory. While you're there, experience this exotic Asian country, its culture and its people. You'll have plenty of time to enjoy the Olympics and the opportunity of discovering this unique country at your leisure. A fabulous prize for the European quiz champion of Going for Gold.
Yes. And so this is it, stretching all the way back there to last autumn and up to the Christmas semi-finals and then the semi-finals that we had just there last week. We're at it. This is the day. Now, already our three daily winners so far this week are into what I call the first round proper, and my, don't I get teased about that, which means that our other five contestants who started the week with us, now one of them will go through to that first round. It's a beat the buzzer contest again, contestants, as you know, the contestants, two from Austria, one from Scotland, one from England and one from Wales. All of them have had good runs, very good runs in Going for Gold. And now the first one of them to get 2 points here will go into the first round for today's final. It's 1 point for each correct answer. So contestants, Peter, Richard, Sue, John and Michael, if you're ready, we'll go. What is our name? We are South American Indians who ruled an empire that extended... Scotland, Richard.
Aztecs.
Is not the correct answer. Austria, John Erickson.
Incas.
The Incas is the correct answer. Well done. 1 point. 1 point so far for John. And I must remind you, contestants, wait until I've said either correct or incorrect before you hit those buzzers again. What am I? I am a muscular, powerfully built cat with a long body, short leg. Scotland.
Cheetah.
Is not the correct answer. The rest of the... Austria, John.
Tiger.
Pardon?
Tiger.
Is not the correct answer. I'll continue. England, Sue.
Lynx.
Is not the correct answer. That means Peter and Michael, the rest of the question is for you. I'll continue. Buzz in when you think you know the answer. Short legs and a large head. My coat is short and pale yellow to dark brown. Michael.
Lion.
A lion is the correct answer. That gives you one. So, hands on the buzzers again. Who am I? I am a silent film actor and director who created... Scotland, Richard.
Charlie Chaplin.
Is not the correct answer. Michael from
Wales. D.W. Griffith.
Pardon?
D.W. Griffith.
No, I'm sorry, that's not the correct answer either. Anybody else? I shall continue with the answer, with the question. The classic deadpan character in conflict with mechanical monsters. My lifelong trademark was a never... Austria, John Erickson.
Buster Keaton.
Is the correct answer, John. Well done indeed. Okay. Well... John Erickson, John Erickson from Austria, who I think, in all honesty to John Erickson, had hardly said a word for the first 3 days this week. And when it counts, there he goes through to that first round. But before I go to the first round, my great thanks, and I'm sure a great round of applause, to Michael Jones from Wales, to Sue Balaam, Richard Leslie, and to Peter Call from Austria, Scotland and England. Thanks for being with us throughout the series and Going for Gold. Well played, all of you. Right. So the first round and the final is between Daphne Hudson from England, Paul Wallace from England, Peter Schmidt-Barr and John Erickson, both from Austria. One way or another, this is between Austria and England. Let's find out who goes through the first round. Going for gold. So, final day on Going for Gold, as we said indeed at the very start, which is why we're in the good suit. And there are the four contestants who are into the first round proper, the very last first round in this series of Going for Gold. And they represent England, two English people, Daphne Hudson and Paul Wallace, and two from Austria, Peter Schmidt-Barr and John Eriksson. You know the rules, let's get straight on as we wish you good luck, first of all, in today's contest, contestants. It's the Beat the Buzzer round. Three of you will go through to the next round. The first three to score 6 points will so do. Questions in categories worth 1, 2, or 3 points, and we begin with a general knowledge question for 1 point. With what human organ do we associate a pacemaker? Paul.
The heart.
The heart is the correct answer. You're off the mark. Paul, you're off the mark. The category is geography. Select.
Two, please.
A 2-point question on geography. In which country are the towns of Cork and Limerick? Paul.
Era, Southern Ireland.
Era, the Republic of Ireland, Southern Ireland. That is correct. That takes you to 3, Paul, and the category is rock and roll.
I'll try 3.
3 to double your score and go through to that next round. Produced by George Harrison, which other ex-Beatles' first solo single was? Paul.
Ringo Starr.
Is correct. It don't come easier in that first round. Well done. Well done. OK, nobody had a chance even to get to a buzzer while Paul was on such good form there, and he goes through to our next round. So, with the scores level for John, Peter and Daphne, general knowledge question for 1 point. With which field event are the styles Western Roll and... Daphne.
High jump.
High jump on the Fosbury Flop. The category, Daphne, is famous women.
3, please.
3-point question on famous women. What nationality was the writer Karen Blixen? Daphne.
Danish.
Is the correct answer. Daphne, that takes you to 4. The category is wars. Select.
2, please.
2-point question on wars. What name is given to the brief war of June 1967 won by... Daphne.
Six-day war.
Is the correct answer. Won by the Israelis. OK. Well, so Daphne and Paul representing England have gone through. Well, as now it's a fight between two Austrians, and they're side by side, so it's up to you, Peter and John. Here you go. General knowledge for 1 point. What do we call a polygon with 6 internal... Peter.
A hexagon.
Is the correct answer. Gets you off the mark. Peter, the category is famous Williams. Famous Williams. In...
Famous Williams.
Williams, yes.
Well, a 2.
A 2-point question. Which Italian composer wrote the opera William Tell? Peter.
Rossini.
Rossini did indeed. Peter, the category is the weather. Select.
A 3.
A 3-point question to double your score and put you in the next round. What term exactly describes the temperature at which water vapor begins to condense in the... John.
Boiling point.
Is not the correct answer. In the atmosphere, Peter. We're out of time. I wanted exactly the word dew point, and you didn't have it. So, general knowledge question for 1 point again. In which Asian country did the musical instrument called the sitar originate? Peter.
In India.
It did indeed. You're on to 4. Peter, the category is sport. Select.
A 2.
A 2-point question for a win for you. In play, how many players are there on an ice hockey team? Peter.
6.
Is correct, Peter. You've got there. Well done. Peter, off you go. Well, there you go. I know we've had so much fun and enjoyment, and it's been a delight to meet John Eriksson. He takes it fatalistically. There he was, not doing so well for 3 days, then suddenly in when it mattered, and then, John, it just wasn't your day. John Eriksson from Austria, thank you very much indeed for being
thank
with
you.
Us on Going for Gold. Great contestant. Thank you. And it's still a battle between England and Austria, because it's Peter Schmidt-Barr from Austria, Paul Wallace and Daphne Hudson from England. They're now ready to play 4 in a row. Thank you very much. Just for a second before we go on and play four in a row and get closer to our winner on Going for Gold, cast your mind back to a young lady who was with us here on Going for Gold, Valerie McGee from Northern Ireland, whose husband and her family run a bakery. And when she came to contest Going for Gold, she made us a little cake. Now look at the cake that she's created and given to us for the final here on Going for Gold. So Valerie, if yourself and your family are watching in Ulster, thank you very much indeed. We shall enjoy the cake. It's wonderful. Bless you. Right, so now, on with our four in a row round. Paul and Daphne from England and Peter from Austria. Paul, you get into the round first. There are the categories: world cinema, Europeans, technology, and autobiographies. Paul.
I will try technology.
You will try technology. Paul, will you come and join me here, please, for your solo round on technology? Paul Wallace, who's been written up in the Nuneaton newspapers in England. Well done to have got so far. You must be happy with yourself, Paul.
Oh, whatever happens, well, it's been a great time.
Great. Thank you, Paul. Yeah. We'll put those 40 seconds on the clock for you. There you go. On technology, Paul, you will have all 40 seconds to answer correctly four in a row or be credited with your highest score. And, Paul, on technology, your time starts now. Beginning with A, what is the name of the European rocket used for commercial...
Ariane.
Is correct. The first mass production of what substance was made possible by the Bessemer converter?
Steel.
Correct. By which acronym is sound navigation and ranging?
Sonar.
Sonar is correct. With reference to computers, what do the initials RAM stand for?
Random access memory.
Is correct. Four in a row. Well done, Paul. Well done. Right. That's it. Paul Wallace got some of them quickly, waited on the others and got them all. Four correct answers, four in a row. Daphne Hudson, world cinema, Europeans or autobiographies?
Autobiographies, please.
Daphne, will you come and join me here, please, for your solo round on autobiographies? Daphne, you know the rules probably better than I do now. We'll put 40 seconds on the clock for you now. There they go. You'll have all those 40 seconds to answer correctly four in a row on autobiographies or be credited with your highest score. Daphne, on autobiographies, your time starts now. Whose autobiography, Mein Kampf, was published in 1924?
Hitler.
Correct. Name the distinguished American playwright and ex-husband of Marilyn Monroe who has just published...
Arthur Miller.
Is correct. The Russian author whose autobiographical writings include Childhood and Boyhood is Leo who?
Sorry?
The Russian...
Leo?
Tolstoy. Is correct. The Prelude is a leading autobiographical poem from the Romantic period. Who wrote it? Pardon?
Wordsworth.
Yes, he did. Four correct answers. Well done. Right. That leaves Peter Schmidt-Bauer with a choice between world cinema or Europeans. Peter.
I'll take Europeans.
You'll take Europeans. Peter, will you come and join me here, please? I'm sure I don't have to tell you, you need four in a row. Because if you get anything less, well then, Daphne and Paul are in the final. But four in a row puts you in a triple tiebreaker. Peter, we'll put 40 seconds on the clock for you now. There they go. You'll have those 40 seconds to answer correctly four in a row. Peter, on Europeans, your time starts now. The famous German who was the governing mayor of Berlin from 1957 to 60... Is correct. In 1986, the socialist Marie Suarez was elected president of which country?
Portugal.
Correct. The French writer who wrote Les Misérables was Victor who?
Hugo.
Correct. Which French president was once finance minister under Pompidou?
Mitterrand.
No, you just got to stand. What was the nationality of the second Secretary General of the United Nations, Dag Hammarskjöld?
Norwegian.
No, Swedish. The Austrian actress-singer who popularized much of Kurt Weill's music was Lottie who?
Don't know.
No, Lenya. In which country was the scientist Marie Curie born?
Poland.
Correct. What is the ecclesiastical position in Britain held by Robert Runcie?
Archbishop of...
Correct. What is the occupation of Pierre Boulez? Oh, Peter, hard luck. A big sigh goes up. Peter, I'm sorry. Peter, hard luck. Well, there you go. There you go. Peter Schmidt-Bauer was an absolutely fantastic guest. The slow, silent one, we called him, along with Bob Wessenberg, who was from Norway with us there before Christmas. We remember them all. We remember all our contestants on Going for Gold. Thank you very much, Peter Schmidt-Bauer, for being with us. A round of applause. Well done, Peter. Well, no contestant has failed to do themselves proud, and no country from all the 15 countries in Europe has failed to do itself proud, whether it was Austria, Sweden, Denmark, Norway, no matter where they came from. But in the end, England is in the final. It's Paul Wallace against Daphne Hudson. Let's see who's going to be the European quiz champion. Thank you very much. This is the final of Going for Gold. After 23 weeks, 5,000 questions, 15 countries, and 140 contestants, it's a battle between England and England. But at least it is a battle between a gentleman and a lady. Paul Wallace here from England and Daphne Hudson from England. You know the rules. You might wish to wish yourselves good luck before you start. OK, and this is the final. As a result of this, one of these two contestants will be the European quiz champion and will win that trip to the Olympic Games in Korea. Paul, you got into this round first. The first decision in this final is going to be yours. The category is oceans, and there is a clue for you watching at home. On oceans, Paul, will you play or pass?
I will pass.
You will pass oceans, as
thank
it were,
much.
To Daphne Hudson, who says thank you very much indeed. And on oceans, Daphne, your time starts now. I am part of the North Atlantic Ocean, which encompasses the Bermuda Islands and is elliptically shaped. I was first... Daphne.
The Bermuda Triangle?
Is not the correct answer. It means, Paul, you have control of the game and time continues now. I was first mentioned by Columbus, who crossed me in his famous voyage of 1492. A combination of conditions have combined to provide a stretch of ocean which is... Paul.
Is it the Sargasso Sea?
It is indeed the Sargasso Sea. Answered in the tree zone. Answered in the tree zone, which means that, Daphne, you are playing catch-up. The subject is painters. There's a clue on the screen for you watching at home. On painters, Daphne, play or pass?
I'll play.
You will play on painters, and your time starts now. In 1632, I was born in my family's tavern in the marketplace in Delft, the city in which I was to spend... Daphne.
Vermeer.
Vermeer is the correct answer. Answered in the four zone. And that means, Paul, you're playing catch-up and the next decision is going to be yours. The subject is warfare. The clue is on the screen for the people watching at home on warfare, Paul. Play or pass?
Pass.
Pass on warfare to Daphne, right? Daphne, you're on four. Paul is on three. On warfare, your time starts now. I am a military vehicle which originated from a development of the tractors produced by the American Holt Company, the British Admiralty's Landship Committee in... Daphne.
A tank.
Is the correct answer. A tank is the correct answer. In the four zone. Daphne, that takes you very close indeed. But Paul, you're on three. You're playing catch up. The subject is Hollywood. The clue is on the screen for you watching at home. On Hollywood, Paul.
We'll have to...
Yes, Paul, you have no choice now. You're on three to Daphne's eight. On Hollywood, your time starts now. I was born in Connecticut in 1917, left fatherless at an early age. I was an adventurous youth. In 1940, I married my high school sweetheart. I often... Paul.
Errol Flynn.
Is not the correct answer. It means that, Daphne, you have control of the game and time continues now. I married my high school... Daphne.
Robert Mitchum.
Is the correct answer, Daphne. Well done. Well done. Daphne, come back in here. Well done. Well done indeed. Daphne, it means that Daphne Hudson is the winner of Going for Gold. Hold on a minute, well done, hard up call. Daphne Hudson is the winner of Going for Gold. She's the European quiz champion, and Daphne, there's your tickets to the Olympic Games. Well done, Daphne Hudson, congratulations. Commiserations to you, Paul Wallace. You did absolutely brilliantly. You don't go away empty-handed by any means. You also win this fantastic prize.
As series runner-up, you'll be able to enjoy the 1988 Olympics on your remote-control 24-inch colour television featuring stereo sound and teletext functions. We wish you many hours of happy viewing with the compliments of Going for Gold.
Well done, Paul. Everybody is now saying, as Paul has just said, I shouldn't have passed the tank, I knew the tank, but there you go. Well, it's been hectic, hasn't it? 92 programmes, as we said, 23 weeks, 5,000 odd questions, 140 contestants, and didn't all the competing European countries do well? From me and from all the contestants and everybody involved in Going for Gold, goodbye and thanks for watching us. Let's go over here, guys. Daphne, well done.